round, round, get around.
I get around.
Yeah,
get around, round, round. I get around.
I get around.
Good to see you.
You too. Welcome to the home of William S. Hart.
Wow, I'm really excited. This is the home of the famous film star.
Yes, it is. So, you want to come in?
Yes.
Okay, come on in.
Gorgeous. I love all the detail.
Yeah, he did a lot of work.
So this is William S. Hart. Or Bill Hart, as you call him?
Yes, this is our guy Bill right here, our world-famous movie star that lived in this house.
World-famous.
World-famous, yes. Just as famous, just as popular to his public as somebody like Brad Pitt is to us.
Wow. So, this is famous horse Fritz?
This is Fritz right here, yes. The very first famous horse movie star in the entire history of the Hollywood industry right there.
Really?
Yep. Hart and Fritz met on the set of a film and they loved each other so much. So Hart would use Fritz in most of his movies. And Fritz became very popular with the public in his own right. In fact, we have it on good authority that Fritz received more fan mail than Bill Hart did.
Ooh.
That's how popular he was.
Ooh.
So, but the two of them, best of friends. You would never guess that there was any kind of rivalry between the two of them. Fritz was actually brought out here to Newhall when he retired from his movie career.
Okay.
And he lived the rest of his days on this property as well. So
William Hart was an actor and a director for silent films, mostly westerns?
That's correct.
Did he ever film any of his movies up here?
He did film at least one that we know of right here on this property. It was his second to last movie that he made. And ultimately, it was Fritz's last movie that he made.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
What is that movie called, do you know?
It's called Singer Jim McKee. And unfortunately, it is one of the silents that have been lost. So we do not have a chance to see it. We would love to watch it, but we have enough of the stills from the film to know that he used his bunkhouse, which is about halfway down the hill from this house here, as one of the sets for that movie. So.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's interesting.
The living room. It's the largest room here in the house at almost 1,200 square feet in size all by itself.
Wow.
And such a large room because this is where Hart would entertain all of his friends when they would come over to hang out with him here.
And he had some pretty famous friends, didn't he?
Yes, he did. One of his best friends was actually the comedian slash actor Will Rogers, who spent quite a bit of time up here at this house. And we can actually thank Will Rogers for the bearskin rug right here on the floor. It was a gift to Hart from Will Rogers. Yes, it was a real bear. This is an Alaskan Kodiak bear, which is the type of grizzly that you find up in Alaska.
Look at the size of his head alone.
Well, that's the thing. If you talk to Kodiak, Alaska, they will tell you that these are the largest bears in the world. We saw the horseshoes downstairs that lived here, but he also owned a number of dogs. And we actually have representations of his two favorite kinds of dogs right here. The English Bulldog. There were a number of those guys that lived in this house. And then what looks like a Dalmatian here, but is actually a Great Dane. He owned a number of Great Danes. So we have our life-size cutouts here for our young visitors so they can see just how big a Great Dane is and how big these two were. This is Prince and Gal, to be exact.
Prince and Gal.
And they were his last two dogs that he owned before his death in 1946. And he decided to turn one of the bedrooms in his house over to the two of them. So that's the room we're standing in right now. But this was also his favorite room in his house.
I was going to say, did he hang out in here?
He hung out in here all the time with his dogs. And you know who else would hang out in this room with him? Fritz.
Fritz?
The horse? Oh, yes. Those two doors right over there open up onto what used to be a back patio for the house. And it's been sealed off, as you can see today. But in his day, he could just open the two doors and he'd let the dogs and the horses wander in and out of this room.
Oh, my goodness.
At their will. So you can tell, favorite room right here.
Aww.
In this house.
Hanging out with his buddies.
Hanging out with his buddies, yeah.
And then the thing that appalled me, that safe behind you?
Yes. This safe right here, which was a film prop Hart used in one of his movies. And when he brought it here to the dog's bedroom, he stored the dog's treats in this safe.
Which were?
Yes, See's candy.
He gave his dog chocolate.
He did give his dog chocolate.
This is such a beautiful house, and with all the stairs, I'm just wondering, do you have special arrangements for physically challenged people to come visit?
Yes, actually we do. If you call us in advance and talk to the staff, we can set up an alternative tour for those who would have difficulty with our staircases inside,
okay.
Where we do actually bring you in through the second floor of the building, yes, because the house is bi-level, so we can bring you in through the back door and into the second floor living room without the guest having to go up and down any of the stairs around here. So just give us a call in advance so we can make sure we have the staff on hand to accommodate that.
Great. And then you have several annual events here.
Yes, we do. So coming up, one of our big events is the annual Silence Under the Stars fundraiser. That's held every August, the second Saturday in August to be exact. And it is a barbecue dinner, a silent auction, and they screen a Bill Hart film outside on the big screen under the stars.
That sounds nice.
Yeah, they have live music to go with the film. So it's a very wonderful evening. It's in August, so it's gorgeous weather out here at that time. And tickets for that event are on sale. You can go to friendsofhartpark.org to purchase those tickets.
Okay. And then your main website is?
Hartmuseum.org.
Hartmuseum.org. Great.
Yeah.
And I brought my passport
book. Well, let me give you your sticker.
We are on page 38 in this edition. And these passport books we can get at the Leonis Adobe Museum or any participating historic site that holds them. I suggest calling the historic site first to see if they have any available. And you can get more information about the passport program at passporttohistory.com. Rachel, thank you so much.
Thank you, Michelle. It was
really
great.
I really enjoyed this.
Yeah,
so
it was
much.
Great to have you guys, and thank you. And let us know if you have any questions. We're always excited to see new faces up here at the museum. So.
Adios, amigos. God bless you all, each and everyone.
Get around, I get around,
yeah,
get around, round, round,
I get around,
get around, round, round,
I get around,
get around.
Strip. I gotta find a new place where the kids are hip.